Welcome everyone. In the previous video, I have provided the definition of indiscernibility relation and also stated the analogy between the relation database and the information system, that how it is being represented in tabular form and how rows are called as tuple and columns are called as attributes. And we have also seen how indiscernibility relation partitions the universe. So extending the idea of indiscernibility relation, we are going to look at another concept in information system known as reduct and core. So there are two concepts that we will be looking today, reduct and core. So the link of the previous video is being provided in the description. Kindly have a look. So let me start. So what do we understand by reduct? First of all, reduct is a short form of redundant. So what do we mean by redundant? Redundant is that it is ambiguous or not clear. So reduct is also that two attribute set are equal, then they may be reduct, but they may be redundant in the information system, but it is not required that it is redundant. So we will look at what is meant by reduct. So let me first define what we have defined so far. So we have defined the information approximation space for information system as U, comma A. Then we have stated the assumption that we define another set B, which is a subset of the set of attribute A. Now keeping these two in mind, reduct is defined as reduct satisfies the two properties. So reduct satisfies two properties. First property is that indiscernibility relation of set B with respect to the approximation space must be equal to the indiscernibility relation of set A. That means the element which are in the indiscernibility relation must be equal in both set. So this is the first property. The second property is that the B must be a minimal set. B must be a minimal set. Minimal attribute set. This is minimal attribute set. So whenever these two conditions are satisfied, we say that it is reduct. So it is being represented as reduct of information system, or it is also being represented as reduct of A. So RED is short form for reduct, and whether we are defining for the complete information system or we are defining just for the attribute, so either way we are defining the reduct. So this is the definition of reduct. Now we will explore how reduct is being calculated through an example. Yeah, is obtained through an example. We will have a look at how reduct is being obtained through an example. So this is the example that I have discussed in the previous video, where I have been given 6 objects and 4 attributes. So, and there are different values for each attribute. Now let me so first of all let me look from the min property, which is that indiscernibility of set B must be equal to indiscernibility of set A. So thus attribute set A has 4 attributes: gender, hair color, eye color, and age group. Now if I take the subset as gender and eye color, and we will try to find out whether these two attributes must be there or is redundant in the in this information system. So here my information system, as I have already stated, that is just defined as the tuple of X. Here I am considering the whole universe. So I am considering whole universe, not the subset X, A, then V, A. Here V is defined as the union of values of each attribute, union of VA of each attribute, for each attribute. For all attributes belonging to A. So V and the row is my function. So here row is my function, which is a mapping from U to A to give a value as VA. So this is the general definition of information system. Now we will try to find out the reduct of this information system. So first of all, the indiscernibility of set B. So what objects are present in which? Now let me look at, so black and male. So P1 and P6 are one equivalence class, or we can say one partition. So this is one element, one member. So another element is brown P2. Then we have P3 and P4. Then we have P5. So there are, as you can see, there are 4. So based on the indiscernibility relation of set B, we have divided the universe into four different equivalence classes. So this is about the indiscernibility relation of B. Now we will have a look at indiscernibility relation of A, set A. So as there are no values which can be considered in the same class or grouped in the same class, therefore all the elements are different. So here we will be having six equivalence class or six partition. Now so these are six equivalence classes with respect to set of attributes A, and we have four equivalence classes with respect to attribute set B. Now if we compare that, they are not equal. So that means eye color and gender are not said to be reduct, as it is not satisfying the first property. But if I remove the complete object P6, and if I remove, now I am taking these two equivalence classes because all other equivalence classes in set B are minimal. So second property is being satisfied. Now if I look at the first property, that it must be equal, then if I considered P1 and P6, it is not minimal because it can be further reduced or divided or partition. So if I remove P1 or from P1, P6, if I remove P6, and from P3, P4, if I remove P3, then the indiscernibility relation of Now taking the universe, it is not a reduct. But if I take only the object P1, P2, P4 and P5, which is a subset of the set of universe consisting of six objects. Now my set of objects has only four. So it can be Now the information system, instead of considering the whole universe, will be considering only the set of objects X. So now I have to redefine my information system. So my information system will now have this set tuple of set X, A, B, and row, and here I am considering X as P1, P2, P4 and P5. Now we will try to find out whether this satisfies the property of reduct or not. So indiscernibility of B is P1, P2, P4 and P5, and indiscernibility relation of A is also P1, same as P. If you look carefully, they will be same. So, as per the first definite property of reduct, both these conditions are being satisfied. And also look it that B is being the minimal set. Every element in the set B is minimal. So it cannot be reduced further. So it is satisfying both the properties of reduct. So now we can say that reduct of A are object P1, P2, P4 and P5. So the reduct of A are object P1, object P2, object P4 and object P5. Now if in this case example, now if we look from the universe point of view, the gender and eye color are not reduct, but if you take the subset from the universe and try to formulate a reduct, then we will look that gender and eye color are the attribute which are in the reduct set. So this is my reduct set elements which are present in the reduct, and this is based on the properties attribute set gender and eye color. This is considering the attribute gender and eye color, we get the reduct as 4 objects P1, P2, P4 and P5. So if in the previous example, if I consider P6 and P4 being present in the set. Now if I look from this point of view, like P1 and P6 and P3 and P4. So there can be 4 possible pair, like P1, P3, P1, P4, P6, P3, P6, P4. So there can be 4 pairs formed from this, and all of them will be a reduct, as it is the minimal set, and the minimal set in A and minimal set in B as well. So now we will have 4 reducts possible. So there are 4 reducts possible. Here from this example we can see that there are 4 possible reducts. But suppose if I take a example where there are hundreds of such set, so it may be like in this example, I have 2 options, either to pick this or pick another element. So in that way, we can have (2U) possible cases. So being this, and U can be very large, and U is very very large. U is very very larger than 1. So in real life U can be between 10,000 to or more than 10,000. So 2^10,000. So if you try to do this computationally, it will take a very long time. Hence finding a minimal set in the reduct calculation is known as the NP-hard problem, because we don't know the exact solution, and that's why it if I reduce that problem to a very suppose to 10 objects, it's still calculatable. If I take 20 objects, still calculatable. So any objects between 30 objects to 35 objects is still calculatable. So that can be solved using dynamic programming approach, that finding minimal subset. So it is similar to the finding subset problem in dynamic programming concept. But if we take more than 35-40 objects, then we don't have a computational power to calculate that, and also it will take a long year to compute, and we don't have that patience to wait for the result. So now I have defined all that. Now let's look at what are the all four reducts. So I have given the example of one reduct. Now I will write the four reduct that I have explained. So here P1, P2, P4 and P5. So this is based on one attribute. Now there are many attributes, and for different attributes there can be different reduct. And so considering only one reduct, I am getting 2 power u possible cases. So there can be many infinite cases. So another way to look from that is from the attribute point of also. Considering single attribute, is it resulting in reduct or not? Then we will take 2 attributes, then 3 attribute set, 4 attribute set. In that also we will have to find whether the elements in the B set and set A are equal or not. So in that way also it is computationally expensive. And finding the minimal set from that from the set of reduct possible reduct we have obtained is a challenging task, and computer scientists are still working on that field. So P1, sorry about the bad writing, so there are 4 possible reduct, which I had already explained just a few minutes. So there are 4 possible reduct. Now if we look from this example or from this reduct, then if this is being repeated in this is being same, that P2 and P5 objects are present in every reduct set, right? So this is known as the core because it is present in every reduct set. So if that object is not present in the reduct set, then there is some misunderstanding or wrong interpretation of data. So this is the idea of core, that core is the, so this is based on the attribute set gender and eye color. So what is core? The core is the intersection of reduct. Here I have written reduct of way, because I am considering only the attribute set gender and eye color. I am not considered the whole information system. If I have considered the reduct of all information system, I would have written as reduct of information system, and from that I will have to find the core. But based on the attribute gender and eye color, I can say that P2 and P5 is a must. So, must in a reduct set. So, this is the definition of core. That core is the intersection of all the reducts. So, based on that, our reduct set are P2 and P5. So, thank you for your attention. Hope you have understood something from this